The Harlequins sprang into the Warhammer 40,000 universe with their colourful patterns and gymnastic abilities back in 1988. And in this video, we're going to show you how to paint an Eldari Harlequin in the style of a rogue trader Harlequin. But first, we need to undercoat our model, and for this we have used White Scar. For our first section, we'll be doing the red and yellow checks. For this, we'll need Evil Sun Scarlet for our red checks and the outline, then we'll be using White Scar to tidy up any mistakes, and then we'll be using Bad Moon Yellow for the yellow checks. So we're going to dip into our pot of Evil Sun Scarlet. I'm going to thin this down quite heavily because we need it to be a really thin consistency so it lasts on our brush. Take a little bit more. Make sure that you use the smallest brush you can. For this, I'm using an extra small artificer brush. And now we can start on the cloak. For this, I'm just going to turn them around. And the first step is to make diagonal lines with a good amount of space between them. Don't worry if they're a little bit chunky, we can tidy that up before we do any of the colours. Do two lines on this side, and then I'll carry on in a moment, but what we're going to do is we're going to do the mirror opposite on the other side. So we're almost making an arrow. After those first lines are down, now we're going to go with the opposite direction. And for this, we can always start at the top of the cloak because it is ruffled and it is the easiest place to start. I'm going to just slowly bring down that line, slowly twisting it as I go. Now don't worry, if you do make a little bit of a mess, we're going to tidy that up in the next stage, and do take your time. Remember to make sure that your paint is nice and thin, and that you have enough of it on your brush as well, but you don't want too much because it will pool heavily, and we want a nice straight line. Next, what we're going to do is fill in the red checks, and what we're going to do is just do it by row. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to start by filling this one here. We're going to avoid this one and this one, and we're going to fill the one directly below it. Then what you're going to do after that, while you do the whole thing, is you're going to miss that and then you'll start opposite. And don't worry if you do get a little bit onto the white, we're going to do tidy up stage next. With the red checks done, now we can move on to White Scar. We're going to use this on the white areas just to tidy them up before we use our next colour. Just take your time and make sure your paint's nice and thin. You can always do multiple layers. Now that's tidied up, we can move on to Bad Moon Yellow, and we're going to pop that on the white areas on the checks. For this, you might need a couple of layers just to build up the yellow, because I'm using a little by little. Don't worry if you get some of the yellow onto the red, you can always tidy up afterwards. Now that the checks on the outside of the coat is done, we can move on to the green. And for this we'll be using Striking Scorpion Green Contrast for our base coat, then Beale Tan Green for our shading, and Creek Khaki for our highlight. So we're going to dip into our pot here, and we don't need to thin it down, so I'm just going to take it straight out the pot. And then we can apply it to our model. So now we're going to pop the green onto the left leg and the left arm and the lapels of the jacket, but not inside the jacket, as we want to do that another colour. With the green now dry, as you can see, I've put it on the lapels and the collar of the jacket as well. And now we can use our Beale Tan Green to shade the recesses. So we're just going to take our brush and we're just going to be careful, just pop it into where the folds of the cloth are. Don't worry if the paint pulls into the recesses too heavily, you can always take a clean brush to take it off again. And now we're going to use our highlight or Krieg Khaki, and we're just going to pop that onto the highest points on those folds of cloth. With the green now finished, we're going to move on to the magenta. And for this, we're going to be using Doomfire Magenta for our base coat, Caribou Crimson for our shading, and Pink Horror for our highlight. So we're going to dip into our pot here, just like before, we're not thinning it down. I'm going to make sure we don't have too much on our brush. And then we can start popping it onto the model. And for this, we're going to pop it onto his right glove, the inside of the jacket, and half of his chest plate, his mohawk, and half of his face plate. Next, we're going to use Caribou Crimson for our recess shade. So we're going to pop it on the mask mostly there, just because it's got some nice details. I'm going to move it around a little bit because I don't want it to pull too heavily, and get it into that ear as well. And make sure you get into the underside of the coat as well, but make sure it doesn't pull too heavily on the flat areas. And for our highlight, we'll be using pink horror. So we're just going to use this to outline the edges of the mask and any details on the glove and the mohawk. With the magenta now done, we can move on to the white. And for this, we'll be using Soulblight Grey for our shading. Then we'll be tidying that up with Corax White and then a final highlight of White Scar. So we're going to dip into our pot and we're not thinning it down, so we're just popping it straight on. So for this, we're going to apply it to the middle tabard and then on the half of the face and the chest. If it pulls too heavily, don't worry, take a clean brush and soak it up. Now that the shade is dry, we can move on to our Corax White. We're going to use this to make a layer on top of the shade, and we're going to make sure that we don't get into the recess areas, and we're just going to give it a nice coverage. And now we can use our highlight of White Scar. With our white now finished, we can move on to the black. And for this, we'll be using Corvus Black for our base coat and Dark Reaper and Thunderhawk Blue for our highlights. So I'm going to just dip into the pot of the Corvus Black. I'm going to pop it on a palette. I'm going to just thin it just a little bit. And then we can pop it onto our model. Now for this, we're going to paint this right boot here and then the sleeve as well on his jacket on the same side and the glove on his opposite arm. You can also paint the hood behind his mask in the same colour. Now we're going to use our first highlight of Dark Reaper. We're going to put this around the edges of any of the gloves and the boots. You may want a couple of layers of this because it is quite dark and will blend in with the black a little bit. With that dry, now we're going to move on to our Thunderhawk Blue. And then we're going to just use that as an edge highlight, so we're just going to pop it right on the top, on the pointiest parts where it's really raised. With the black now done, we can move on to the silver. And for this, we'll be using Lead Belcher for the base coat, Nuln Oil for the shade, and Stormhost Silver for the highlight. So, just dip into the pot, pop on the palette, a touch of water, and then pop onto the model. So we're going to pop the Lead Belcher onto the gun and some smaller details. You might need a couple of coats of this. Next, we're going to add our shade of Nuln Oil. And finally, we're going to use Stormhost Silver for our edge highlight. With the silver now done, we can move on to the gold. And for this, we'll be using Retributor Armor for our base coat, Mortarian Grime for our shading, and then Skull Crusher Brass for our edge highlight. So we're going to just dip into our pot here. I'm going to pop it onto our palette next to our other colours. I'm going to thin it down just a touch, and then pop it onto our model. So for this, we're going to put it onto the belt and also the hilt of the sword. Next, we're going to add a couple of coats of Mortarian Grime, just so you get that aged vintage look. Now with our shade dry, we're going to move on to our edge highlight of Skull Crusher Brass. Now that the gold's done, you may have noticed I've painted the blade in black afterwards. I've done this to avoid smudging any gold onto the painted black, so it's just a little easier to do it afterwards. And now that's fully done, we can move on to the basing. And for this, we'll be using Astrogranite Texture Paint and then Nuln Oil to shade over afterwards. So I'm going to dip into the pot, just going to hold it gently. I'm going to take the large end of the scoop. I'm going to take a good amount off, make sure it doesn't drip anywhere. And then we can pop it onto our base. There we go. I'm just going to make sure that it's nice spread outwards. And you can use the smaller end to get around any feet or rocks. And this may take about roughly an hour to dry. Now that the texture is dry, we're going to add our Nuln Oil. So I'm just going to get it into all these little divots and cracks. And also I'm going to do it on the stone that the Harlequin is jumping off of. With the shade now dry on the base, we can move to dry brushing it. And for this, we're going to use Administratum Grey. So I've got my brush. I'm going to dip it into the pot here. I'm going to take a little bit. Then I'm going to pop it on the paper here. And what I'm doing is removing most of the moisture from the paint. I'm going to go in circle motions just to make sure that it's all in the bristles. And then we can apply it to our base. Now, we're going to be very gentle with this because we don't want to go too heavy with the dry brushing. We want to add it to the tops of all the little ruts on the ground. You can also dry brush that stone as well that he's leaping off. With the base finished, you can now go and paint the rim in a colour that matches the rest of your army. In this case, we've used Steel Legion Drab. Now with our Harlequin painted and based, it's ready to somersault over enemies to maim and mesmerise. So just a couple of things to remember while you're painting. When it comes to doing the diamonds, take your time. Just make sure your paint is thin and your brush is pointed, and the lines will be a lot easier and you'll get some really cool designs. Well, I hope you enjoyed this painting video, and we hope you enjoy painting your own rogue trader Harlequins, and we'll see you soon. Bye-bye!